Hey everyone, thanks for watching. So today's video is going to be all about some of my high maintenance makeup products and if I think they are worth the extra time that you have to put into using them. So if you want to see some of my makeup products that I think are the most high maintenance, why don't we go ahead and get started. So the idea from this video came when I was talking about this product recently and I found myself that I kept saying the words high maintenance. High maintenance, high maintenance. And I was like, what else do I have in my collection that's high maintenance? And what is actually worth the extra time and energy and effort that you have to put into it? And that product that I am talking about that inspired this video is from Dose of Colors. It's from the Desi and Katie collaboration, and it is the Girls Eyeshadow Palette. By the time that I'm filming this video, the collection is no longer going to be restocked. They did have their final restock earlier in the week, and now the collection is going to be no longer, but if you were able to get your hands on some of the collection that Desi and Katie came out with Dose of Colors, maybe you think the same thing I do, that this palette is a little bit high maintenance. The reason that I say that is because the shadows are pretty interesting, and these two right here, you really have to use with water. And I knew that, and when I reviewed this video and played with it, you know, I said in here, I ended up not loving the palette as much as I thought I was going to, but I knew exactly what I was getting, and I still bought it because I was excited to support two of my favorite influencers, Desi Perkins and Katie or Luster Lux. I was excited for it, and I was excited to try something different. And you know, just because I ended up not loving it as much as I did doesn't mean that I still don't occasionally enjoy reaching for it from time to time, but it definitely is high maintenance and can take some extra effort to put into. So like I said, these two you have to use wet or else the fallout is very extreme and they don't show up as much, but all four as a whole really apply better with your fingers. I have acrylics and I just do not like putting my fingers in makeup. I don't know what it is. I don't like swatching makeup. I just don't like putting my fingers in makeup. It's something that I've learned about myself since starting a YouTube channel. So I don't enjoy that, and I have nails. It's really hard to kind of get in there all of the time. With the brushes, they're okay. They're not great though. You need to use your fingers, so that part really does bum me out. So this palette is definitely high maintenance. It takes extra work. You kind of have to use these shadows differently than you would some of your normal eyeshadows. And so with these shades, I really only use them as like eyeshadow toppers, which that's not always my favorite thing. I don't reach for a lot of eyeshadow palettes where I know I'm using it only as an eyeshadow topper. But again, I knew that going into purchasing this. I didn't return it. I haven't given it away or anything. And I still am going to keep it around in my collection because I do think that it is worth the extra time because the shades can look pretty darn cool. And I've kind of changed my mind about this one a little bit because when I first got it, like I said, I wasn't super stoked about it. I was kind of like, I don't know. I wasn't reaching for it a ton. And then I went away one weekend and it was a girls weekend. We were going on a girls trip and I was picking out the makeup that I wanted to bring. And I really wanted to bring this because I feel like you can do some cool looks with it. Especially this shade is probably my favorite. Here's a swatch. I did do it dry, so it doesn't have as much oomph as a wet shade, but I really like the glitter to it and the shimmer. I think it does look really cool. And then the purple shade next to it is pretty similar to it. Actually can be pretty intense and take an eye look pretty dark, but it is the cool shimmer. I really enjoy this one as an inner corner or on the inner part of the lid. And this is a really nice bronze shade with some shimmer in it as well. So I ended up starting to enjoy this one more than I originally thought that I was going to. I didn't want to get rid of it. I still wanted to keep it around, and I've actually been changing my mind. So I would say that this one is worth the extra time and effort that you have to put into it, but it definitely is high maintenance. Another eyeshadow palette that is high maintenance, you guys probably do not see this one coming, but this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Subculture palette. Yeah, this palette be high maintenance, man. I do still have the brush in there, so let me take that out. But the Subculture palette, I mean, unless you were living under a rock, you've probably heard of Subculture Gate. It really took YouTube by storm. It was pretty wild. So I do like my Subculture palette. I really do. I haven't returned it. I didn't want to give it away. I bought it myself. I enjoy this palette. I think I've come up with some pretty fun looks with it. It definitely pushes me out of my comfort zone. The reason why I think it's high maintenance is because when I go into this palette, I really have to kind of stop and think and stare and try to envision. Just looking at it, I don't immediately have that ping, this is what I'm gonna do with my makeup today. I'm like, okay, what is it I'm gonna do with my makeup today? And of course, one of the biggest reasons why this is a high maintenance palette is because these shadows, the formula of these eyeshadows really caught everybody off guard. I think it's because of the way it was marketed. And again, I don't wanna get too much into it because I've made a video about this, everybody else has made a video about this. But the way that it was marketed, we thought it would be the sister to the modern renaissance. This is a completely different formula, and they are incredibly, incredibly pigmented. I feel like this is the only eyeshadow palette in my collection that I have to use in such a specific way because of how these shadows are. Like, you just have to so slightly tap your brush in here and you're going to get so much pigment. And I enjoy that, but also as someone who's a beginner and I'm not always the best at blending makeup, that definitely can make it more challenging for me. But again, like I said, I like this palette and I like the looks that I've been able to come up with it, but it truly is a high maintenance palette in my opinion, of course. Is this palette worth the extra time? That actually, I almost kind of want to lean towards saying no, just because there are so many other eyeshadow palettes out there that are so much easier and friendlier to use. And this one is definitely very challenging. And it's hard for me to say no though, because I like this palette. I will continue to use this palette, but sometimes I just don't have the time or energy for subculture. Like, there's days where I'm like, I'm gonna use the subculture today. And then by the time I get around to doing my makeup, I'm like, oh my gosh, I can't do it today. I don't have the strength. I don't have the strength to use you subculture. So definitely a high maintenance palette. I would love to hear what you guys think about it. Do you think this is high maintenance and do you think it's worth the time? Let us know. So keeping on the eyeshadow theme, the next items I want to talk about are the ColourPop Super Shock eyeshadows. So these are, you know, some of the first products that ColourPop ever released. They come in these little individual containers like this, and then these are what your eyeshadows look like. These are some of the first items that I did purchase from ColourPop myself. The reason that I say that these are high maintenance are for a couple of different reasons. A, they're high maintenance to store. These little individual guys, and when you have a lot, which I don't even have that much, but I've seen people who have huge collections of it. I'm like, how do you store that? And even with what I have, I'm like, how do I store these? So that's a little bit high maintenance on my end. Another reason is because when you do close these, you get your order in, like when I would order them, there was always a little card in there and it always said, make sure you close these really tight, like real tight, because they dry out very fast. And I made the mistake with one of my eyeshadows not closing it enough and it dried out very quickly. And it was just, you know, it was only $5 down the drain, but still, you don't want to throw away any money. That sucks. But a big, big reason why I think that these are high maintenance is also because you do have to use your fingers to apply these. It's really the best way to apply the ColourPop Super Shock eyeshadows and also the Super Shock blushes. Super Shock is incredibly difficult to say, but you really do have to use your fingers. And I know some people might not have a lot of makeup brushes and maybe you enjoy applying with your fingers, but to me, no matter what, I still consider that a bit high maintenance because now you have makeup on your fingers and you gotta go wash your hands. Or if you're like me, you wipe them on your sweatpants. You should see what my pants look like right now because they look ridiculous because I have makeup all over them. So that's why I say that. So even if it's something that you prefer to apply with your fingers, I still think that's a little bit more high maintenance than simply reaching for a brush because now you have makeup all over your hands. Not the most high maintenance ever, but I still wanted to include them because I feel that way about them. And I would say, are they worth it? To me, honestly, not really. Especially with having to store them the way that I do, I would put them into a little container and then put them into a drawer. And honestly, I would kind of forget about them. You know, I have all of my palettes set out real nice and pretty. And when I'm deciding what makeup to use, I'm like, oh, okay, there's this palette, there's that palette. I'm not going into my drawer, into my little container to pull out all of my ColourPop single shadows. And also, when creating an eye look, if you have your palette there, you kind of will have at least the majority, if not your full eye look in there. But with ColourPop, you're like, okay, I want this shade, and then I want this shade over here, and then I want this shade over here. It just makes me not reach for them as much. And then especially how having to apply them, in my opinion, they aren't worth the extra time. But the new ColourPop eyeshadows that came out, their pressed eyeshadows, are miles, miles better in my opinion than the Super Shock shadows. I find them to be high maintenance at all, and I would highly recommend them, especially over these guys. These were just never quite my fave. So I'm gonna end it with the two foundations that I feel like are high maintenance. This first one here is from Estee Lauder. This is the Double Wear Nude Water Fresh Makeup. This is a bit of a newer foundation from Estee Lauder. They have the original Double Wear, and then they came out with the Water Fresh Double Wear foundation. So this is much more liquidy and less full coverage than the original Double Wear, from what I understand, because I haven't tried that foundation. The reason, there's a couple reasons why I think this is high maintenance. First of all, this is a $42 foundation. It doesn't come with a pump. That's just rude. That's simply rude in my eyes. You might say, but Samantha, you do have a pump on yours. Yes, I know. I had a wonderful subscriber see my video of me being like, Estee Lauder, you played us with no pump, and she actually sent me one. I didn't even know it was coming. I went to my P.O. box, got the box out, and I opened it, and I was like, did I order a pump in my sleep? What did I do? And luckily she had a note in there. I was like, oh my goodness, I'm glad you put that in there, because wow, was I ever confused. But she sent me a pump, which has helped me get on with this foundation a little bit more, because the problem is, you know, I have other foundations that don't have pumps either. Most of them are drugstore and quite cheaper, but I have other foundations that don't have a pump, and it's not as bad. It's not ideal. Pumps, I think, are just the best. This one, the issue with this not having a pump and having to go out and spend $10 to $15 on another pump, which then makes this closer to a $60 foundation, which is crazy. The hard part with this is that when you pour it out, it is such a liquidy foundation. It's going everywhere. I've gotten foundation all over me, my shirt, my floor, my chair. I have gotten foundation everywhere because of how liquidy it is. You do want to shake it before you use it to try to help a little bit, but that doesn't make it a super non-liquidy foundation, and it gets everywhere. And I mean, you can see that it's on the pump. I'm always trying to clean this after I use it. I try to clean it off because otherwise it looks like this, and that just is what it is. So I feel like it's extremely messy. It's extremely pricey for what it is, especially when you ideally will want to go out and purchase of the pump to go along with it. Those are my biggest reasons why I think it's a high maintenance foundation. And then also, when I apply it, because it is so liquidy, I feel like it can come off pretty streaky on my skin, and I really have to take the extra time to make sure everything is all blended out and make sure it's blended out smoothly and I don't have any sort of streaks or lines on my face, because that has happened with me several times when I've tried using this foundation. So you just kind of have to take a little bit of extra time as well, which is a big bummer to me. So honestly, do I think this is worth the time and energy and effort for the Estee Lauder Double Wear foundation? Not really. We really didn't get on very well, me and this Estee Lauder foundation, but I just think when I go to use it, I can't just use it like a normal foundation and just pump some out and go on my face. Like, I'm having to pay attention to it. I'm having to make sure I'm not spilling everywhere. A lot of times when I pull out this foundation, I pull out a paper towel and I put the paper towel under it to try to catch where the makeup is gonna fall, because otherwise my room, you know, we just repainted it. I don't need to repaint it with my Estee Lauder foundation. That's a little ridiculous. And then maybe if the end result was like something that I absolutely loved, I would be much more inclined to say, yes, I do think it's worth it. But especially with having to deal with the streaks on my face, and I don't necessarily love the way it sits on my skin or the benefits that it gives to my skin. So for this one, for me, it's not worth that extra time. It's just not. I'm leaving the most controversial product for last. This is another foundation. This is from Fenty Beauty. This is the Pro Filter Soft Matte Long Wear Foundation. Man, I say controversial because people get really offended when you don't like anything from the Fenty Beauty brand. Unfortunately, this foundation really just didn't work out for me. I think because of my skin type, I'm pretty normal, but I can lean on the dry side, and I don't think this is great for people with dry skin, in my opinion, and from the reviews that I've seen. So that definitely didn't work out the best for me, but I was feeling super conflicted with this foundation because I tried so many different ways to use it. You know, everyone's like, oh, you need to use a really hydrating primer, and I tried. I went through so many of my hydrating primers trying to find the perfect match for this one. I couldn't find it. I used my Farsali Rose Gold Elixir, which is an oil, and I used that underneath it with, sometimes with a very matte or very full coverage foundation, I use that oil because it just helps. It gives me the right combination. You know, I thought maybe I need to bring in like the big guns for this foundation to make it look right, but then it was too oily on my skin and I looked too dewy, and I was like, I can't, I can't find the right combination for this. And so when I reviewed it, it was interesting reading the reviews because I heard people say you have to like mix primers to get this to work. I had a lot of people tell me I have to mix this with another foundation. Why do I need to do that? I don't mix any of my other foundations with other foundations. The only reason I would mix a foundation with another foundation is to color match. Like when I am like self-tanned, but I'm using one of my favorite foundations that is in a lighter shade, I can mix in a darker foundation or, you know, some type of liquid bronzer to color match me. But I don't have to mix a foundation with another foundation to make it look nice on my skin. I simply don't need to do that with any other foundation, so I don't feel like I need to do that with this foundation. But it was interesting just reading those comments on my review video and all of the ideas and suggestions that people were giving me, and I'm just thinking, no, that's way too time consuming. I don't got time for that. No. So that's what I think about the Fenty Beauty Foundation. I do think it is high maintenance, especially because I still have not been able to make it work for me, but especially reading the suggestions from other people. Kudos to you all for, you know, taking the extra time and the extra 5 steps to make this foundation work for you. You are dedicated. I appreciate that about you. But for me, it just doesn't work out. So the Fenty Beauty, I think it's a high maintenance foundation. Do I think it's worth it? Not for this girl. If it's worth it for you and you just love the way it looks when you mix it with 2 other primers and 2 other foundations, you do your thing because that's awesome and you get to do what you want to do. But for me, it is not worth the extra time or energy. Alright guys, so that is going to do it for my high maintenance makeup products. And if I think they're worth the extra time and energy, let me know what you thought of this video. If you enjoyed seeing it, do you own any of these products? Do you agree that they're high maintenance? Do you think that they are worth it? And what are some of your most high maintenance products that you have in your makeup collection? Let me know if you'd want to see a part 2 of this video as well, because I actually had more items in here, but I decided to cut out a few and just really focus on the eyeshadows and the foundations for this one. But if you would like to see a part 2, let me know, because I have more products that I could definitely talk about. And of course, if you guys did enjoy this video, I hope that you will give it a thumbs up. I hope that you will also consider subscribing before you go, and I will see you guys in tomorrow's video. Bye.